PS4, and I'm going to be unboxing the PlayStation Vita today. I picked it up right in the morning. It was the first edition bundle, so I got mine from Future Shop. And I also got a couple of games. I got Uncharted and Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3, and I also got some accessories. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to unbox my Vita and some of the accessories and games, and I'm expect a full review in the coming weeks for the games, Vita, everything. So stay tuned. Please comment, rate, subscribe, share, and keep on watching my channel, because there's going to be a lot of videos up, not just for the Vita, but for probably for 3DS, for PlayStation 3, everything. Anyway, let's get started. Yeah, okay, so this is my PlayStation Vita right here. I also picked up a 16 gigs from, it was from EB Games. I live in Canada, so my first edition, it's the Wi-Fi bundle. I also got a card case, so what this is, it holds your card along with your memory stick. I got the screen protector. I didn't get the horror screen protector because I didn't have time to ship it. So what I got is a Sony screen protector. It looks pretty good, but my only problem is that it's not a full body. It's only the front. So I'm probably gonna use this until it comes with two. So I'm probably gonna use this until I get my Hori screen protector full body. I picked up Uncharted, Golden Abyss, and I also picked up Marvel vs. Capcom 3, Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3. My bad. And okay, so let me just tell you some stuff about why I got this. The reason I got this is because, as you can see, it's like $59.99 in Canada. And it's 16 gigs. The reason I got this is because on my PSP, I probably had 4 gigs, and basically that wasn't enough. I download movies and whatnot, right? And sometimes I watch it on the go, and I found that I never really had enough space because I had to like keep on deleting my games. And some games like I actually bought from the PSN store, and it just wasn't enough. So I'm hoping that 16 gigs is probably gonna be enough. On the back, it even says, like, if you can see right here, it says 8 to 4 full games, 12 movies, 4,568 songs, and 3,200 photos. So I'm guessing that's good enough for me. My Vita also comes with 4 gigs, but as I said, it's not enough. And anyways, let's get started on the unboxing. Alright, so this is my first edition bundle. It comes with little deviants, everything that the US one includes, and it comes with a case, so I really didn't have to buy a case for it. So it says right here, it includes the Wi-Fi PS Vita 4 gigs, limited edition case, and little DVD. It's actually pretty big. Like, if you see it, it's massive. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna open it right now. Been waiting like all day to open this, so where's the thing? Here, right here. I know it's kind of bootleg because I don't really have a knife right now, and I'm kind of lazy again, so I'm using my screwdriver, and it's good enough. Okay, I'm opening it. Drum roll. Okay, I'm just kidding. Okay, so it comes with another box in a box. The original PlayStation Vita box. It comes with that box in this box. How weird. Alright, I'm gonna put this aside and look at all my stuff over here, what I got. I don't really know what this is. Oh crap, AR cards. Oh, I didn't know. Okay, so the Vita actually comes with some AR cards. Pretty cool. Kind of like the 3DS, but... this is the protection plan. 4 gigs. Okay, I told you it came to 4 gigs. Little deviants. And also comes with the case, which I'm gonna show you right now. So the PSV case, yeah, people are right, it doesn't really smell that great right now. Nah, let me open it. Okay, so that's pretty cool. Anyways, much more than expected, and I really didn't know this, so I don't know, you have to put something in here, and what I learned is you don't put your PSV in here, don't do nothing in here. On the top, it's like 4 little slots to put either your memory cards or your game, so that's actually pretty useful. Let me put this away for now. Okay, so I'm gonna put a little deviance away for now because
I'm gonna play it, but like, I don't know, I'm not gonna play right now. Okay, now I'm gonna unbox the actual PlayStation Vita. So here it is, and let's get started. Okay, this is like a far more better tape. I just don't like how they tape these systems, cause like, I don't know, sometimes it's hard to open. Okay, I think I opened it. Yeah, I did. Anyways, I'm sorry if I'm being too slow, but the reason I made this channel is because basically, every time I tried finding a review for games, because sometimes I usually buy them the first day depending on what it is, and I never really found it, so I'm going to be the person that does the reviews on the first day. I usually get my game on the first day. Anyways, right here is, okay, it says, welcome to the world of PlayStation. I opened this, and what is this? It comes with, I guess it's the charger. It's like a PSP, so it's the part to put your charger, you put it in, and okay, it comes with a USB, so that's pretty cool. Unlike PlayStation PSP, you have to buy your own you have to buy your own USB, so I'm gonna put this away for now. Okay, so it's actually the PS Vita quick start guide. Like some long page or whatever. Okay, got the guiding crunch, and right here is the PS Vita. It's like right here. Okay, I'm gonna open it. Crap. Anyway, sorry about that. I don't know why my camera just kind of lagged. But anyways, this is the PlayStation Vita. I just opened it right now. You can see right here. What I realized is that up here is where you take this out and you put in your games right there. Okay, well, I want to close it. Hold on. Okay, right here. I thought this was the place where you put your memory card, but it's actually not, the USB. Where you put USB in. The volume buttons are right here and here. Power's right here. As you can see, the shoulder button, it's actually pretty different. Like, it's bigger. It's way bigger. And the Vita itself feels nice. The analog sticks, like, right there. PlayStation button, and you put your memory card in this slot right here. I don't know if you guys can see, but there's a tiny slot right here, and you put in there the headphones and whatnot, the buttons, and the back. It's just like, it's super glossy. It's like super glossy. Feels really nice, but I'm pretty sure it's immune to scratches and whatnot. And if you guys are wondering how big the PlayStation Vita is, I'm just gonna show you this compared to the PSP and just 3DS. Alright, the Vita right here is, okay, this is the Vita. This is my PSP. The width, the Vita is way more wider, but you can't really tell because of my camera. It's probably that much bigger. And it just feels nicer. Compared to the 3DS, as you can see, this is my 3DS. The height comparison is just like, this Vita is like massive, huge. Yeah. What am I gonna do? Okay, I'm gonna open this game card thing right here and show you guys what it looks like. Hold on. I always have problem opening these things, I don't know why. And the Vita is great, but everything has a problem, and I'm not gonna ignore the problems and lie to you like other people and tell you that there is none. There is problems, but basically I'm gonna explain all of it to you guys, and I'll explain why I chose that in like my next video. So make sure you guys like comment, rate, and subscribe. I'm just trying to open this right now, so hold on. Yeah. This is what happens when you don't have a knife. Okay, there you go. Okay, so. Okay, it feels pretty nice. It's like really good. You put your games in 1, 2, 3, 4, and there's like 4 on the back. And right here, it's the place to put your memory card. Right there. Over here, it says PS Vita on the top. I'm gonna open it. So it's a tiny opening right here. And it's like that. Pretty cool. So you put 4 games up here and your memory stick card right here. And your memory card, another one goes over here. So 2 memory cards and 8 games in total. I'm gonna show you my Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom, how the game card looks like. It's pretty small. As you can see, there's no manual, and the reason behind that is the manual is on this card, so you see it actually on your Vita, and this is how it actually, how small it is. Pretty small. It's like almost a SD card for like a camera and whatnot. So before I turn my Vita on, I'm actually gonna charge it because I'm actually weird like that. I wanna like charge it first. And then I'm gonna do it. Even though people say that, oh, you can play without charging, I'd rather just charge it first. One problem is the 16 gigs. So basically, the 16 gigs, everyone's saying it's, I don't know, they're having a problem with it. The memory card, it's small itself, but like, it's small is good, like to me. Back then, I imagine like they're floppy disk and they're like this big. Okay, sorry about that. So right here is the 16 gigs, and I found out that a lot of people actually have problems with this, so I'm actually going to review this right now. I think it's great, but the thing is, it is pricey. Like, as you can see, this is 16 and it costs $59.99. 32 costs like 100 something, so I think that's pretty stupid. But at the same time, it's really small. And if you're complaining about like how small it is, it's actually really good because like, think about it. Back then, a floppy disk would be like this big. Like, this is like tiny as heck, it's like puny. And if you are complaining, that's pretty stupid because I'm pretty sure this is bigger than your dick, so I don't know why you're complaining. Actually pretty good. And that's my first, that was my unboxing of the PlayStation Vita. So stay tuned for a walkthrough of the whole Vita. I'm gonna basically review every single thing in the Vita. And I'm also going to review games, do walkthroughs, playthroughs, let's plays and whatnot. There's actually more to come for this channel, and this is my first video, so it might not be that good, but expect more to come.